and hopefully it's recording here. It is. This is Roosevelt with Auto Network. We're outside of San Francisco with Volkswagen for the launch of the new Golf and the Golf GTI. And I have as my special guest, Mr. Jeff Sand. And we're here in, it looks like an old hangar of some sort, Jeff.
It's actually an old warehouse.
It's an old warehouse.
Yeah.
Now, we have this big new slogan behind us, Ready, Set, Golf. What's that all about?
For us, we wanted to develop a campaign theme that as we launch the cars throughout the next 7 to 8 months here, we wanted to develop a theme that would work across all the different car lines. And for us, as we started to dive into the target and how we wanted to roll the campaign out, we wanted to develop a theme that would work across everything. And was as we looked into the derivatives of the vehicles, whether it was the Golf R or the GTI or the e-Golf that's coming out, what we really found was that this car is a great enabler for our target and really allows their target to live a larger life. And what we did is when we set out to make this campaign theme was something that would enclose all of that. And Ready, Set, Golf for us really encapsulates that theme and that feeling that really our target is going to resonate with.
Now, have you found over the years the ultimate buyer for the Golf has changed?
It has. It's changed a little bit with the introduction of the TDI. It's gotten a little bit older and it's got a little bit more college educated. But it still has very much a lot of the same attributes in terms of the target, very much an urban setting. So some new, but very much a lot that's very similar to what has been buying the car in the past.
Now, with all the new media and ways of reaching customers and with all the noise that's out there, how are you going to get above the fray and get people to pay more attention to your advertising?
That is a great question. As we've evolved our campaigns, we wanted to do be mindful of the traditional ways, whether it's television or print or digital, but we also want to make sure that we're doing it in a very unique way. So having some big moments in time, for example, advertising in the World Cup, in the television, but also doing things, with a different twist. Even though we're in the World Cup, we're going to be doing some things very unique in the social space, as well as doing partnerships with GoPro and Shark Week and things like that to make a bigger presence within very traditional media sources.
Now, is there a big difference between the TDI buyer and the GTI buyer?
There is some slight differences. The TDI buyer tends to be a little bit older. They tend to commute to the city. That's why they want a car that has the fuel range of the TDI. And the GTI is a little bit younger buyer. So it is a little bit different, but the mindset is very much similar. They share a lot of the same psychographics.
So what would be a couple of the main features of say, the TDI that you would want to put in front of an initial buyer, something that would really make them say, hey, I want to jump in this car and drive it?
I think for us, we really kind of try to showcase the no-compromise aspect of our vehicles. And TDI, I think, does a great job of that. You get the fuel economy, but you still get a turbocharged engine. You get the practicality, the size, and the versatility of the Golf itself, and you get a great looking vehicle. So it's really this no compromise aspect that I think TDI really encompasses all those different areas.
And the ultimate TDI buyer is male, female, age?
It tends to be male, and it skews a little bit, I'd say, in the close to the 40 range. But again, it's starting to skew a little bit younger, but that's who the buyer is right now, but it's definitely a vehicle as we grow the lineup and the TDI exposure, we hope to get that even younger and much more wider.
And what about for the GTI buyer?
That's predominantly male, a little bit younger. It's more in the late 20s, early 30s, as opposed to the TDI.
So when you really start marketing the GTI, for instance, what's going to be the main point of the advertisement?
For us, it's really the performance of the vehicle. It's really a great example of German engineering, the driving dynamics, the handling, as well as the torque that comes in the engine. but also the fact that you get the versatility and the practicality and the size of a hatchback all in this one great package.
So when Jeff comes out of his house every morning and jumps in one of these Golfs, what puts the big smile on your face that I see right now?
It's definitely the GTI for me. I love it. It definitely fits my lifestyle, living in an urban environment, having a car that fits your lifestyle, your needs. It's really, for us, we talk about it being the right size, you know, and the right size and the way it fits your life. And that to me is the really the great examples of what Golf has to offer for people.
Great. Jeff, thanks for taking the time.
Thank you.
This is Roosevelt with Auto Network. We're here outside of San Francisco with Volkswagen for the launch of the new 2015 Golf TDI and the GTI. And as always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. See you next time.